Good morning, students. Welcome to online teaching session of Academic World School, Bemidra. Today, we will start with a new topic, that is speed and flexibility. In the previous video, we studied about what is strength and what is endurance. And in the first, we discussed about what is sports training is. Sports training is the systematic way to learn or to gain speed, endurance, flexibility, agility, speed. Because of that only, that is the combination. If you have good flexibility, if you have good endurance, if you have good speed, if you have good strength, then only you can do good in all the sports. So today we will discuss about speed and flexibility. Clear? In this one we will discuss about what are the types of speed, what are the methods to develop speed, because speed is a most crucial thing in the sports training. Because if you don't have speed, you cannot perform anything in any sports. After that, we will discuss about what is flexibility, what are the types of flexibility and methods to develop flexibility. Because if you have good flexibility, the chances of injury will reduce. Clear? So we will start with first one. What is speed is? In simple terms, speed means to cover the maximum distance in minimum time. Clear? It is also depend on the lower extremity, because you have to run faster. For that one, your leg. If your leg is strong, then only if the strength of your leg is good, then only you can speed faster. You can increase the speed, you can run faster. So that maximum distance covered in minimum time, that is called speed. Clear? Now, what are the definition of speed? First is, speed is the capacity of an individual to perform successive movement pattern at the fast rate. Means, whatever the work you are doing, whatever the work you are doing continuously. And how fast you can do that. For example, if I have to lift this object continuously, how fast I can lift it continuous manner, that is called speed. How fast? Speed means fast. Clear? Again, I will repeat, speed is the capacity of an individual to perform successive movement pattern at fast rate. It is written by Bell. Remember one thing, whenever you are writing the definition, clear definition, you have to mention the name of the person who written the definition. Clear? Second one is, speed as the rate at which a person can propel his body or part of his body. Written by Nelson and Johnson. What is the propel means? Propel means forward direction. Forward direction means if you want to run, you have to bring your rear leg in front. Then only the continuous manner will go, then only you can go forward. Clear? Again, I repeat. Speed as the rate at which a person can propel his body or body part of his body. Propel means forward, for example. Okay? Written by Nelson and Johnson. Clear? After that, we will discuss what are the types of speed. First is reaction ability. Reaction. By the name itself, you will come to know. By the name itself, you will come to know. Reaction means react. Clear? Reaction ability means how you will react to the given situation. Reaction ability is also divided into two parts. First one is simple. Second one is complex. What is simple reaction is? Simple reaction means whatever the work you are doing, you know. Means determined pattern. You know what you have to do. That is called simple reaction ability. For example, you know if the ball is there, you have to kick the ball. If the ball will come to you, you will kick the ball. You know you have to go in that direction. That is simple. What is complex mean? Complex means undetermined movement pattern. Means you don't know what to do. For example, in cricket, if the bowler will do the bowling, you don't know where the ball will come and from where I have to hit. That is complex reaction ability. Clear? After that, next is acceleration ability. Acceleration ability means to accelerate. You have to know when to accelerate, when to reduce the speed. For example, if you are running 200 meter, 300 meter, 400 meter, 500 meter, 800 meter. 100 meter is the distance, short distance races. 200 meter is the short distance races. 400 will also come in short distance races, means speed work. You have to know at what time you have to accelerate the speed. What is acceleration means? From the stationary position to gain the maximum speed, that is called acceleration speed. So, acceleration ability means the person have, if you know how, when to accelerate, how to accelerate, then only you can get this ability. Third one is maximum speed. Maximum speed means from the stationary position, how fast you will get your maximum or optimum speed. For a good athlete, it will take 6 to 7 seconds. 6 to 7 seconds to gain the maximum speed for the well-trained athlete. Clear? And the well-trained athlete can only, remember one thing, the well-trained athlete can only maintain his maximum speed. Only for 20 meter, 20 to 30 meter. Not more than that, remember, clear? That is maximum speed. After that, explosive strength. Why explosive strength? This comes under maximum speed. If we will take the example of short distance races, 100 meter, 200 meter, 400 meter, you know what is block start? If you saw the races, in there is a block where the person has to take the position. Clear? If the person having the good explosive strength means it is the ability to overcome resistance with high speed. Means you have to know at the command of go, at the when the official will give the command or trigger the bullet or gun, at that time you have to run. Then how immediately you will react, that is called explosive strength. If you have a good explosive strength, you can gain the maximum speed as soon as possible. Clear? Next is speed endurance. What is speed endurance? Speed endurance means it is to maintain the speed as far as possible. Means you have to constant speed for a longer duration. Example, constant speed for a longer duration. In this one we can say 400 meter, 800 meter. Is the example 400 meter and 800 meter. Is the example of speed endurance. Because you have to maintain your speed for a long duration. Constant speed for a long duration. We already discussed about what are the types of speed. Okay, you understand what are the types of speed, but you have to know how to develop your speed. There are two ways to develop the speed. First one is acceleration run. Acceleration run means to gain the speed from the stationary position up to your maximum. That is acceleration means. For example, if the person will standing in a starting position, from the starting position up to the time when he took his maximum speed, that is called acceleration run. For example, if the person running 800 meter, if the person is running 800 meter and he is taking the best timing is 1 minute 40 seconds. We will take the example 1 minute 40 seconds. For the maximum speed, he will cover 800 meter. Example, 800 meter covering 1 minute 40 seconds is the best timing. So, for the first 400 meter, first 400 meter. The person has to cover 400 meter. Person has to cover in 49 seconds. Then the rest 400 meter person has to cover in 51 seconds. Because it is not possible for a person to maintain a high speed for a longer duration of time. That's why if the person has to run faster in the first 400 meter, it will take 49 seconds. Then for the next 400 meter, if it takes 51 seconds, then only he will cover 800 meter race. That is 1 minute 40 seconds. That is an example of acceleration run. Acceleration run, it doesn't mean the good athlete or a long distance races person has to run faster. For example, if the person has to run 2 km, 5 km, 10 km, if he run faster in the first phases of race, then he will get tired and he will not able to cover that remaining distance. So it will depend on the person how to or to constant speed. Because if he will run in a constant speed in a slow pace, then he will increase his race at the second or third phase of the races. That is the most important thing. After that, second is pace run or races. What is pace run? Pace run means constant speed. Acceleration means, I have written from the acceleration means from the stationary position up to the person will take his maximum speed. Second is pace run. Pace run means constant speed. Constant speed means if the person is taking part in the long distance races. Long distance means 1500 meter, 3000, 5000, 2 kilometer. Marathon 10 km. In that one person has to or athlete has to take care of the speed. For example, if the person will run with a high speed, if he has to run 42 km, then it is not possible for him to cover the whole distance or to complete the race. For that one, he has to manage or to run in a constant speed or in a slow pace. Then only the person can cover his maximum distance. That is the main important of that. Clear? After that, again I will tell you what is definition. Speed is the ability or capacity of an individual to perform successive movement pattern at fast rate. Fast rate means how fast you can perform the same repetition. I already given the example. What is the example? If I am lifting any object continuously at the fast rate, how fast and how much I can lift within a 1 minute? How many times? That is speed. Clear? Second is speed as the rate at which the person can propel. Propel means forward. Because if you want to move your body forward, you have to bring your rear foot to the forward. Then the same pattern you have to repeat again and again. In the running also, you have to bring your left leg or right leg or the leg which is behind, you have to bring it forward. Then again the same pattern you have to repeat again and again. Then only you can propel your body forward. So, propel his body or parts of his body is written by Nelson and Johnson. Clear? After that, we discussed about types of speed. What is the types of speed? First one is reaction ability. What is reaction ability? Reaction ability, by the name reaction only you will understand. Reaction means react. Clear? Reaction ability means to react in a particular direction or task. Clear? First, reaction ability is also divided into two parts. First one is simple. Simple means determined movement pattern. Means you know in which direction I have to go. Or the person or coach already told you or informed you about, yes, now you have to do that thing. By that only you will come to know, it will come to your mind, yes, I have to do that thing. Then you can perform that thing easily. Second one is complex. Complex means undetermined movement pattern. Means you don't know what to do, what will come next. For example, if we take the example of a cricket, if the person is doing bowling, but the batsman don't know where the ball will come, that is complex and where to hit. If we take the example of football also, at the time of penalty, goalkeeper don't know where the ball will come, in which direction. But maybe the person who is taking the penalty, he can hit the ball towards the left of the goalkeeper or right of the goalkeeper or at the top of the corner. That is complex. After that, acceleration ability. Acceleration ability means the person has the ability to gain the maximum speed as soon as possible. If the person has the ability to perform this one or to accelerate as soon as possible, that is acceleration ability. Next one is maximum speed. Maximum speed means to cover the maximum distance or to gain the maximum distance in minimum time or to gain his maximum speed as soon as possible. After that, explosive strength. Explosive strength means, explosive strength, it is the ability of a muscle to overcome resistance with high speed. Okay, it is the example of block start. Example you can write. Block start. After that, next is speed endurance. What is speed endurance? Speed endurance means to run in a constant speed for a longer duration. That is called speed endurance. Constant speed for a long duration. For, if that is the example 400 meter and 800 meter, because you have to run in a constant speed. In 400 meter and 800 meter, speed is also required and endurance is also required. Clear? After that, we discussed about what are the methods to develop speed. First one is acceleration run. What is acceleration run means? Acceleration run means from the stationary position up to you will get your maximum speed. That is acceleration run. Second one is pace run or pace races. Pace run or pace races means to run in a constant speed for a longer duration. It is totally depend on the athlete because the person has to run for a long duration. For example, 800 meter, no. For example, 800 meter, it can be 1500 meter, 3000, 5000, marathon, cross country. Because in that one person has to run in a constant speed and you have to understand at what pace I have to run so that I can cover the full race as soon as possible. Clear? After that, we will come with the flexibility. What is the flexibility means? This is the main topic. This is also a main topic in this one, sports training. Clear? Flexibility means the movement of the joint. Clear? Then, what is flexibility? It is the ability to execute movement through the wide range of motion. Wide range of motion means, we will take the example, if the person can raise the hand up to here, we can say the flexibility of that person is this. Because he cannot bring the hands up. Clear? If the person can join both the hands up, that is his flexibility. We can say that. Clear? Flexibility is also, if you will take the example of the body also, there are four movements of the joints. First is adduction. Second is abduction. Third one is flexion and extension. We can say extension, abduction, adduction, abduction and flexion. These are the four movements of the joint. Remember, what is extension means? Extension means where the angle of the joint decreases. For example, if we will flex the elbow, then the joint of the bicep and the forearm will reduce. Remember, biceps and forearm, the angle will reduce. That is called flexion. Extension is just opposite to the flexion. means increasing the angle of the joint. That is called extension. Flexion means flex. Extension means extend. Clear? After that, what is adduction and what is abduction? Adduction means bring your body part towards the midline. Remember one thing, if you bisect our body from the top, it will bisect the body in two halves, right and left. Clear? Then what is adduction means? Bringing the body parts towards the midline. For example, if we are bringing our hands, that is called abduction. That is called adduction. What is abduction means? Abduction means away from the midline. Means we are bringing the hands away from the midline. That is called abduction. Adduction means add. Abduction means minus. For example. Clear? After that, we discuss about what, understand, the ability to execute the movement through wide range of motion. Clear? Next one, it is the range of movement of joints. Joints, remember. What is joints? Joint is the articulation of two or more than two bones. Joints is the articulation, means where, for example, these are two separate bones, where the two bones will join, that is called articulation. Two or more than two bones join in a one way or in one part, that is called joint. For example, elbow is a joint, knee is a joint, shoulder is a joint. Clear? After that, we will discuss what are the types of flexibility. Flexibility is also divided into two parts. First one is passive flexibility. Passive, what do you mean by passive? Passive flexibility means whatever the stretching exercise we are doing. Stretching exercise we are doing and we will take the help of other. That is called passive flexibility. Means taking the external help. Whatever the exercise, stretching exercise we will do, it will take the help of the external, that is called passive flexibility. What is active flexibility? Active flexibility means whatever the exercise or stretching we are doing and we will not take help of the external. By ourselves we are doing, that is called active flexibility. Clear? Active flexibility means we are doing by ourselves. Clear? Then after that, we will discuss about what are the methods to develop flexibility. First one is ballistic method. Ballistic method means whatever the action we will do by the body parts in a rhythmic way, that is called ballistic. Rhythmic way, that is called ballistic method. For example, if we are rotating our hands, that is a rhythmic way. For example, alternate toe touch in a rhythmic way, that is ballistic method. After that, static stretching method. Static means in a particular position. Remember one thing, static means static means stationary, means in a particular position where we will not move. Clear? Static stretching method means it is also depend when we are doing. For example, for the warm up if we will do or for the cooling down. Cooling down means whatever the stretching exercise we are doing after the training program. Because we have to bring our body parts or joints or muscles in the normal position. Clear? Static stretching method. If we are doing static stretching method for the cooling down purpose, we have to hold the position for 10 seconds. If we are doing for cooling down, we have to hold the position. For 10 seconds. If we are going for the warming up, then we have to hold the position for 20 seconds. It is also depend on the person, what the person has to do. Clear? Static stretching method means holding the position for some seconds. For example, if we are bringing our hands up and then we have to hold for some seconds. That is called static stretching method. Next one is dynamic stretching method. What is dynamic stretching? What is the mean by dynamic? Dynamic means movement. Whatever the exercise or whatever the stretching we will do by movement, that is called dynamic stretching method. Dynamic means movement. For example, if we are doing jumping and we are touching the toes with the right hand, left toe, left hand, right toe, or by walking only we are bending our body forward, that is dynamic stretching method. Step flexibility, we can improve the flexibility. But in stretching, static stretching method, if the person using this one, it will not improve the flexibility. It can be, but in comparison to dynamic stretching method, static stretching method is not good. If you are comparing both, because the person knows the capacity of himself, because he knows how much I can bend the body. Because if the person wants to develop his flexibility, then only he can. By the external help, we can only hold. Because if the external is not there, how we will do that? So, flexibility is also, we can improve by the static also and dynamic also. Clear? Then again I will tell you what is flexibility is. It is the ability to execute the movement through the wide range of motion. Second, it is the range of movement of joint. Clear? For example, I already given the example extension, adduction, abduction, and flexion. What is extension means? Increase the angle of the joint. For example, if you are bringing away both the angles, that is. Clear? What is flexion? Bring the joints closer. That is flexion. Adduction means bring your body parts towards the midline. What is abduction means? Away from the midline. Clear? After that we discuss what are the types of flexibility. First we discuss about passive flexibility, means taking the external help to bend or to execute the movement. Next is active flexibility, whatever the person is doing by himself. Himself means not taking the external help. Clear? After that we discuss about what are the methods to develop flexibility. First one is ballistic method. Ballistic method means whatever the exercise or execute the movement in a continuous manner and in a rhythmic way. For example, alternate toe touch. Clear? After that, static stretching method. Whatever the stretching we are doing in a stationary position and holding the position for some seconds. In that one we discuss about stretching method we are doing for which purpose. If we are going for the cooling down, then we have to hold for 10 seconds. If we are going for the warm up, we have to hold for 20 seconds. If we are doing static stretching method to increase the flexibility, then we have to hold for 30 seconds. For the increasing the flexibility, then we have to hold for 30 seconds. Next is, we discuss about what is dynamic stretching method. Dynamic by itself, we will understand. Dynamic means whatever the stretching we are doing by movement. That is stretching, dynamic stretching method. Clear? I hope you understand this thing. Okay? On the basis of this, speed. On on the basis of speed and flexibility, I give the assignment. On the basis of assignment, you have to complete the assignment as soon as possible and submit it. Thank you.